terms of dealing with gangs in the Bermuda area, which has been confirmed by the Chesterfield Police Department to be at a high volume, is there any plan of action in place, or will this situation be ignored? Ms. Chaffee.
This is something that I've paid close attention to. I often attend the public safety breakfast so I can understand what's going on, and I've seen their gang presentation. I work very closely with the South Captain of the Police Department. We are working with initiatives to help support landlords in evicting anybody that has any kind of gang activity, which you're allowed to, the federal statute allows you to do. We're trying to work on educating people, and they have education for teachers in the school, and they have as a matter of fact, one of the bus drivers brought up that she thought that the bus driver should get this education. That was something I wanted to present to the school board. I took the Police Citizens Academy so I could be aware of all of the issues that our police are dealing with, and they know that I am behind them 100% in trying to make this place, to keep Chesterfield safe, and they know that I will always take their side in keeping Chesterfield safe and prosecuting criminals and not letting gangs take over our community.
Mr. House. The gang activity in Chesterfield is definitely an issue. And in Bermuda, we have a bigger issue than in the other magisterial districts. I think the police department is doing the best that they can. But the issue is they don't have enough help. They used to have community officers. They had one assigned just to the Bensley area, but due to personnel shortages, they had to consolidate into only two community officers within the county. One of them works basically in the southeast, and the other one works the northwest, so on and so forth. But that has always helped, especially on Jeff Davis Highway. Their community officer over there was in touch with the community. He knew where there were pockets of problems. He knew what gangs were beginning to be formed, that sort of thing. And because of cuts in public safety, we have now lost that connection with the community through our police department. And I think that the community officers are so spread out that they're not in touch with the areas as much as they should be. So I think that's the solution, is to bring back our police department to a level that they can have community officers the way they used to be, to stay in touch with the community.
Thank you. Your time's up.
Last question from the audience this evening. Minority business in the county has been on the decline. How would you demonstrate that Chesterfield is business friendly to all businesses? Mr. Krause.
Well, Chesterfield's always been business friendly, I think, to all businesses. But there's always been a bureaucracy to go through to get a business license. If you're going to build, there's a process to go through. There's a lot of things to do, a lot of laps to run before you can get a business started here. Now, I think what needs to happen is we need to cut through that bureaucracy. Some of the minority businesses, just regular small businesses, sometimes they need to have someone walk them through the process. I think a lot of times that could be the supervisor. I think that should be the supervisor. The supervisor should be in touch with business especially. And we know that schools and public safety grow business. And in order to plant the seed in schools and in public safety, we need to prop up business. We need to get business moving, so that we can support schools and begin that wheel turning. So in order to help minority businesses get started, I think that we need to reach out a hand to them and help them walk through the bureaucracy that is our county. Ms. Jacob.
Well, I support businesses, minority businesses.